So, Farihana, the only thing which I will kind of take you through, I know you are addressing many of those pieces. So I will not get into HR operating model and so on. The thing which will be of interest to you is the governance piece and why I made that point. So here, if you look at the data, this is really the discipline divide. Clearly defined HR governance model within HR and with business. So these are the organization who, what they do is they have a discipline of doing this ongoing interaction with business around how do you problem solve. So you can just imagine HRBPs are doing this with a regular cadence, which is broader with business to say how HR can help you, how we have been doing, what needs to be done on priority. Then they are going back and defining those corrective actions and implementing that, driving change management around that. And they are using data to track that. So if you look at it, while all other things, even on the governance items, are yet to mature, the thing which has first started happening for these organizations is this conversation, which looks very much outside in, and everyone else is rallying up behind that with a project mindset to problem solve. If you look at from our perspective, while last as practitioners in this field, last couple of years, we have been saying that ways of working needs to change even before HR transformation happens. If you look at this data, what it says is that ways of working has disproportionate impact. And earlier done, it's better, because in a traditional transformation approach, it used to happen at the end when everything is switched on and that change happens. So to us, this data validated some of that intuitive thinking. And this data is really powerful in the sense when you go back and correlate this to right impact and result, it connects everywhere. And then now navigating to the future, then there is obviously a lot of challenges around people analytics, why it's a challenge, there is a lack of data, how do you connect data to outcomes. But when you look at the response itself, these challenges will remain. So the first step for change is for HR to really step out of the comfort zone and start changing the ways of working, because that also creates the joint buy-in from business. And typically what it does, then it becomes a joint area to address as collaborative approach, then it's business demanding something from HR. So that to us was the aha moment. I will, and that's where we said, we actually said that think of it as a 2x2, and all consultants love 2x2, but we wanted to keep it simple. And we said that now look at scope of governance in the mind of HR. And then that's an important point, and I will want to illustrate it with an example. Think of engagement data. It's such a simple thing. All HR leaders track it, use it. But engagement data, when you report it out and to say that as an, even when you think of experience as an anchor, we have improved overall. That's a great achievement, but that's still on the x-axis, really limited functional view. When you look at the same engagement data and say, by the way, we have improved overall engagement. But when we look at the data and look at newer verticals, look at global locations, engagement is lower. When we look at newer hires, senior new hires who are critical to many key initiatives we are doing, engagement is lower. Actually, and that lower engagement is not only a red flag for talent strategy, it's also a red flag for business strategy for any organization which is going through transformation. Because a lot of transformations will be anchored around some of these themes of global collaboration, of transforming with newer capabilities, which is mostly from outside in. And if they start failing, your business transformation will itself start failing. So very few organizations will actually use this data, take it to literally to their ELT and to board to say that, look, this data is a lead indicator that we are not doing this right. So that's really the change from a scope of governance. And the rationale is anecdotal versus data, because anecdotal, and this we have been experiencing for last, I will say, 3 to 5 years, is the demand on, I will say, ongoing performance. And we get a lot of demand on ongoing performance. Great thing is many times HR and business have together bought into that. And the need is to deploy a new tool. The problem is, tool is not the problem, because when this amplification happens on anecdote and people ignore the fact that data, that even mid-year conversations are not happening with real meat and real impact, how do you expect ongoing conversation to happen? So the problem has to be solving manager behavior, getting the developmental mindset in. But when this anecdotal data drives behavior, anecdotal approach drives behavior, it becomes even more dangerous. So in that sense, a dysfunctional is a better block to be in than to be in the pseudo block where you are assuming you are doing right. You will actually launch a massive initiative based on anecdotes, and it creates challenges. So hence, the ideal way is we are extensive in a scope of governance and outcome, which is more business linked. And from a rational perspective, you need data. So this has become clearer to us. We have always talked about this. But now with the connect where we see organizations doing it, pulling way ahead, I think it's important thing to look at. So that's something which, Faryana, I thought was a connect to the first piece around why adaptable HR is working and who are the organizations who are really making it work, are the organizations who are building on navigating to the future, and that as a discipline, which anchors back to HR governance. So that is something which was stitched for us this time. And it was deliberate, and it's powerful because we had placed the research construct in a way where some of the governance questions were disconnected and at the end. So when we picked up common responses, it was not like that respondents were answering these in sequence. And hence, when the two tallied up, it's a real insight. So thanks, Faryana, for giving me this opportunity.
Yeah, I thought, you know, that last point was really, really important, because as an organization that's going through transformation, I think we need to know where we are at. And obviously, Allied and Petronas have been working as a partner, and you have a good sense of where we are, I guess, Shaswat, as well.
Yeah.
So I think you're right. You know, if we happen to be in that pseudo quadrant, thinking that we're aligning everything towards a business outcome, but really based on opinions and anecdotal views, etc., that's when we get into very dangerous territories. So I think that's really important to point out, especially now that we understand ultimately HR transformation is about the business transformation, and therefore getting alignment of the people in the business to understand where they're heading and how HR transformation will be critical in ultimately delivering the business transformation that we want to achieve.
Yeah.
Thanks, Shaswat.